bring you the Coin Toss. It is presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Taken from the 3-yard line. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. The Wildcats know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much, we could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 22. And he's tackled at the 31-yard line. And he's out of bounds. That's a loss.
A loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings us fourth and seven.
Clement is the punter. It's away, and it's a booming punt. There's a fumble, and the offense picks it up. He's taken down at the 32-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. And he's taken down right around the 24-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Fake and looking to run. He gets hit out of bounds at the 10. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
They'll bring him down around the 7-yard line. Rushing gets 3 yards on the play.
Second and goal.
We've got second and goal. Ball on the 7. He's scrambling. And he's going to be sacked. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Still 8 yards away. Now it's third and goal. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And down he goes at about the 5-yard line. Fernandez gets him about 3 yards with a completion. This will make it a field goal game. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Tackle at the 20-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. At the 22. 2-yard gain on the quarterback keeper.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short gain.
From their own 22-yard line. Second down. Fire. completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. The stop, the 47-yard line.
You know, I talked to so many college quarterbacks who have gone on to be very successful in the NFL, and they all talk about the execution of the play action. And all of them talk about, the good ones, about taking their time and really working to sell the play action and sell the fake. If you don't take the time as a quarterback to really sell the fake, it's going to make it easy on the linebackers and safeties to realize that that was just a fake handoff and to get back in position. But when you really work it and sell it the way that quarterback did right there, that's when it's more effective. It can open up the big play.
Second and seven. Ball on the 50-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Get to that quickly. Brought down at the 36. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. It's picked off.
Really impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
From their own 20-yard line. First down. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, they can just keep their concentration. They'll avoid situations like that.
Tackled at the 17. A 2-yard run by the halfback. Second and 13. Ball on their own 17. Little handoff. He's taken down at the 19-yard line. Short over the middle. Tackle made right around the 26-yard line. Clement awaits the snap. They'll bring him down at the 40. The Wildcats really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
Not a lot of offense in quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. The Wildcats lead 3-0, and we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's good to have gained 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Man left. Three down.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. The tight end's got it for a first down. And he's tackled around the 25-yard line.
First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers. He fights forward to about the 23. Wildcats saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. He's out of bounds at the 18. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
That makes it first and goal.
They come out on an empty backfield. And the end zone touchdown. That was a well drawn up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. And he converts the extra point. A seven-play, 60-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Fernandez from the one. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 25-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. From their own 30-yard line, second down. Good outside run there. First and 10. Ball on the 38. Makes it out to about the 49. It out to about the 40.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Makes it to the 17. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
He gets out to about the 8. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. And this play is number 8 on the drive. It out to maybe the 7-yard line. And so it's another third down upcoming here. They bring him down in the backfield.
The problem at times with pitch outs is they're really slow to develop. And in this case, the defense had plenty of time to swarm to the ball carrier.
There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start. Offense.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. Clement has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He'll take it from the two. Tackle made at the 26. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Quick throw, and he's taken down at the 35.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down around the 39-yard line. They get about 4 yards on the pass, and they'll pick up the first down.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. He's under some heat. And he's immediately tackled.
That makes it first and 10.
Gets it. He's in space. And down he goes at the 12. Over the middle to his tailback. Tackle at the 4. A tight first half of football, and we head to the break. 7-6.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got her back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, it's great, too, is you build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a 5-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games. And you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Welcome back to the action. Second half just about set to begin. We got a tight game here. He sends this one deep. And down he goes at the 17-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And they make the stop at the 34-yard line.
First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's a gain of 5 on one play. That'll make it second and 4.
Slings it out there incomplete.
This quarterback needs to be careful not to use his arm strength to try to force things, because that's when mistakes happen.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. He zips it. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does, and he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. He's on the run. He's all the way home. Touchdown.
Tell you what, this kid is incredible. He's got the moves, the speed, the power. He's the total package.
And he hits the PAT. So a 5-play, 84-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Rushing, Fields at the goal line. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. Only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking, if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He's pushed out of bounds at the 26-yard line. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. They hand it off. Makes it to the 37.
Very well-designed play that time to give them a first down. Linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
Gets out to about the 38-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Second and 9 coming up here. Ball on the 38-yard line. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. He's scrambling, and they get the sack. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
From the 46-yard line, it's first down. And they push him out at the 32.
Cat, no question. He got tremendous penetration and was able to wrap him up for a loss there.
And this is the 8th play of the drive.
Mike,
five wide. Quick pass. He's tackled at the 24. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Big opening. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Tries to buy some time. He's taken down right around the 4 yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive. And it pays off. Touchdown.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
They need to tie it up here, and that's exactly why they're going for two. Pitch play here. He's in for the conversion. It was a 12-play, 80-yard drive, and they add 8 points to their total.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running room.
14 apiece. Clement has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He's to the 20. At the 30. He gets hit out of bounds. Right around the 48-yard line. Kirk, if this keeps going like it has been, we are going to have one exciting fourth quarter.
I just hope we continue to see this kind of execution. It's a lot of fun to be able to watch these offenses make plays, and it kind of has that feel. Whoever does have the ball last and a chance to make a play could win this game.
Really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
And he's tackled around the 40-yard line. First down. From the 40-yard line, first down. Takes it right side for a good game.
Gain of 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
He might not be able to get the pass off. They'll make the sack. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Gets it out quickly. Tackle made around the 28-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
So at the end of the third quarter, we're deadlocked right now at 14. All tied up, and we head to the all-important fourth quarter. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
From the 28-yard line, It's second down. Quick throw out to the receiver. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal. First and goal, fourth quarter, all tied up. What's it going to be? And he's taken down just outside the goal line. This is the eighth play of this drive. The touchdown. And that was a perfectly executed play there by the offense.
And the option is so tough to defend, especially right near the goal line.
And he tacks on the extra point. It was an eight-play, 52-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
It's fielded at the two. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. They get him in the backfield for a loss.
Rushing the intended receiver. That brings up third and 14.
Third and long. This defense digs in here, and it could be their ball game. He heaves it deep. Shot at the pick.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
That'll make it fourth and 14.
Clement awaits the snap. He makes it to the 48-yard line. Kirk, really, you look at the stat sheet, it makes you just shake your head.
I agree. It's a shocker that this game is still this close, and yet at the same time, you wonder which team emotionally is going to be able to finish it and come out with a win.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Straight run, and he's brought down the backfield.
That makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 48. It to the back, and he's stopped behind the line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Yeah. He's going to air it long.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Fernandez is back awaiting the punt. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Talk about a pressure-filled situation. Rushing's playmaking abilities have got him to this point, Kirk, and now he's got a chance to put it away.
Well, you're talking about one of the most explosive players on this field, and if I'm running this offense, I'm finding any possible way to get the football into his hands. He has the potential of taking the ball to the house anytime he touches the ball. It's pressure-packed moments like this where great players need to step up.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Slings it. Tackle around the 27-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Just over a minute left. He's going to try and scramble. Slides down to the ground. Scrambling around, and he tackles him hard at the 33. Scramble. Slides down. 5, maybe 6 yards there on the scramble. To get back in this game in the fourth quarter, this third and long is huge. He steps up. Going deep. Lays it out there. Drops it.
The pass ball is incomplete. Fernandez was the intended receiver on that play. That brings us fourth and 11.
They'll need something really big here out of their quarterback on fourth and one.
Going deep. And down he goes at the 18.
That sure isn't something to see every day, but this is an aggressive offense. They are really testing their opponent right now.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Short over the middle. They'll bring him down around the 16-yard line.
Kill, kill, kill.
The spike will stop the clock. It's the 11th play of the drive. Caught with room to work. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. Scrambling, and they make the stop at the 2-yard line. And he stops the clock with a spike. The offense is down by 7, so this is a very big third and goal. They're on the 2-yard line. He's on the run. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where poise really takes over. Whoever shows it will win the football game. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up.
He got it!
Late in the fourth quarter, and with that score, we are now tied. And the way things are going, we might be going to an extra session or two. The defense calls a timeout. They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Late here in the fourth quarter now in a tie football game. And it looks like Barring another score, we might be headed to overtime. This looks like their last shot to get it to the end zone. Airing it out long. And he's got it. Going the other way now. We're going to overtime. And that's the end of the fourth quarter, and we're going to take this deadlock into overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime.
Just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
From the 24-yard line, it's second down. He's scrambling, heading for the corner. Excellent open field tackle. Quick strike and he drops it.
Number 39, the intended receiver on the play.
And the kicker comes out to try to put 3 points on the board here in overtime. The kick is up. And it is good.
I know they would have rather put the ball in the end zone, but this is still big. Points are points. I think their defense is going to thrive under the circumstances.
And a quick throw. He's pushed out of bounds around the 13-yard line. From the 13-yard line, first down. Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. Pass complete and taken down immediately. A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. 27-24. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.